Hydrogen chloride and ammonia are gases at room temperature. They are highly soluble in water. Dissolved molecules easily pass into air from the concentrated solution. In the gas phase, molecules readily extend beyond the vessels. Ammonia and hydrogen chloride vapors are colorless, but when mixed together, they form white smoke. Let's take a closer look and see where this smoke comes from. Smoke consists of small particles that we can't see with our eyes, but plenty of such particles form a plain gray background. Small crystals of ammonia chloride play the role of smoke particles in our case. Let's see how these crystals were formed. We need to zoom in 1,000 times greater to visualize separate molecules. Now we can observe molecules. There are not only molecules of ammonia, hydrogen chloride, and ammonium chloride, but also plenty of oxygen and nitrogen molecules from the air. We won't consider them anymore because they have no interest for us, as they don't react with anything else here. Let's see how ammonia and hydrogen chloride combine. The nitrogen atom in an ammonia molecule has a lone electron pair that can be easily shared with hydrogen in hydrogen chloride. This new molecule is called ammonium chloride. Separate molecules of ammonia chloride combine together to form a crystal. A small crystal nucleus grows bigger and bigger as new molecules of ammonia chloride join to it. Sometimes a couple of small crystals combine together, giving a greater one. These new crystals can combine in their turn, and so on. This process continues until particles become several thousandths of a millimeter in diameter. These particles form the smoke that we can see. The process of particles growing doesn't stop at this stage. However, growing larger, they become too heavy to fly in the air with ease, and they accumulate on the surrounding surfaces as white powder.